Hi, Home Assistant keeps getting better, and this time I'll show you everything new in the March 2025 release, version 2025.3. This update mainly focuses on the front end with enhancements to view headers, style cards, and much more. Let's dive right in. Before I show you everything included in this release, I want to mention that this video is based on the beta version of Home Assistant 2025.3. There may be still some minor changes before the official release on the first Wednesday of March 2025, but generally these changes are minimal. Starting with this release, you can add a title to the views on your dashboard. You can format these titles using Markdown and even display sensor information. Additionally, you can add badges to the header. This was already possible, but now you can arrange them in different ways, above, beside, or below your title. Quite a few changes have been made to the tile cards this time. When clicked, you can instantly see whether a tile card controls a device or provides more information. If there's no action assigned to the tile card, the icon will no longer have a surrounding circle. You can also display a tile card's features directly within it. This can be useful for adjusting the brightness of your lights, toggling a switch on or off, or controlling your air conditioning directly from your dashboard. Counter helpers now support counter actions, allowing you to manage counters easily from your dashboard. You can choose which counter actions to display within your tile card. You may have already noticed some interaction updates. When you hover over or click a tile card, it slightly highlights, and clicking a tile icon triggers a small extra animation. Tile cards now also support keyboard navigation. You can cycle through them using the tab key. I might not use this feature much, but it's great for those who prefer keyboard-based navigation. The editor has also been improved with new controls configuring your tile card easier. The interface for content layout and features position has also been updated. Work on voice functionality in Home Assistant is still ongoing. If you use Assist with an LLM like OpenAI, responses are now displaying a streaming text. This means you no longer have to wait long for Assist to answer your question. For now, this feature is only available on desktops. As always, this release includes new and updated integrations. You can find them in this list. One change that caught my attention is an update to the ESP Home integration. You can now specify per device whether its logs can be viewed directly in Home Assistant. In addition to all the changes I've already shown you, this list includes even more updates. From now on, your browser will automatically update its cache when connecting to Home Assistant. This means you'll never have to manually refresh your cache after installing a new integration. Additionally, graphs have been improved for better clarity, and trackables on the map card can now be grouped together when they are close to each other. Some changes in each new release may not be fully compatible with previous versions of Home Assistant. To avoid any unexpected issues, review the compatibility list before upgrading. You'll find links to the release notes and a detailed list of changes in the video description below. I'd love to hear your thoughts, so drop a comment and share your feedback. If you find my content helpful, consider supporting me monthly, just like these fantastic people already do. Your support enables me to keep creating videos and growing this channel. Check out the links to Patreon, Ko-fi, and how to become a paid member in the description to see how you can contribute. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't yet. See you in the following video. Bye bye! Okay. Ah, here we go. I might not... features position, features position, 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 position. From now, updates, updates. From now on, updates.